Good morning, dear students. Today, I will continue with English literature and we will take chapter 16. Name of the lesson is The Foolish Lion and the Clever Rabbit. So, this play has been adapted or it has been taken from one of the most famous stories of the Panchatantra, and there are more than 8 to 9 characters who are important, like Leo the Lion, Happy the Hippo, Ellie the Elephant, Speedy the Squirrel, Daisy the Deer, Abu the Ape, Ozzy the Owl, Rusty the Rabbit, and the other animals like Jackal, Antelope, Giraffe, Bear, etc. It will be an interesting play. Let's begin with the play. So once upon a time, there lived a cruel lion in a dense forest. And that lion was very powerful, ferocious, was very arrogant, was very much unpleasantly proud of himself. And he was such a violent animal. And he had a very bad habit. He used to kill the animals of the forest to satisfy his hunger. Soon, the lion became the cause of worry for all the other animals of the forest. So in the drama, you can see the setting of the story is under a big tree where all the animals have assembled to discuss a plan to deal with the lion's action of killing the animals. So Happy was wailing, crying and said, Leo ate my aunt and cousin yesterday. Ellie, he was also sad and said, he took away my baby. Speedy was sobbing. Last week he ate up my entire family. Daisy the Deer, in a whispering, very softly, she said, I had a narrow escape the other day, but I may not be lucky every time. Abu said, in a growling voice, he was very angry. He said, this must be stopped. We have to put an end to all this. But what we can do? Leo is very strong. The lion is very strong and powerful that we can't fight. If he continues to kill this way, there won't be any animal left in this jungle. And the other animals were all worried. They said, what can we do? All the animals in the forest were upset. Suddenly, they heard a voice which came from above. Whose voice it was? It was Ozzy the Owl. All the animals looked up the tree. Ozzy talked to them. She said, I have a suggestion. I think we should offer ourselves to him. All the animals were shocked. They said, what? And few animals also told, as if it weren't bad enough that we now offer ourselves. All the animals started talking to each other, discussing this matter very softly, and they had a very serious discussion. All the animals were quiet now. Then Ozzy the Owl speaks again. Ozzy said, listen very carefully to what I have to say and think also before you all answer to me. You all know Leo is a crazy king. He kills without rhyme and reason. He just kills. Many of you have lost your families. Now, would you like to lose your children to that crazy monster? And who will be left if he kills all the animals in the forest? And who will be left if he kills all our children? So, what he did? He flies down and sits on Happy. Okay, who is Happy here? You all know Happy is the hippo. So, all the animals listen to him as if he is the head. So Ozzy was wiser than the other animals. So Ozzy again spoke, send him one animal. He had a suggestion. What suggestion he had? Send him one animal every day for his lunch. This way he stays in his den and eats only one animal a day. Hopefully in a year or two, this Leo will die, or he will become too lazy and he will become too old that he will be no longer bothered to hunt. So what we will do? we will all kill him without any hesitation. So Abu, who was listening very much patiently, Abu the ape, he was thoughtful and he said, "What Oji says, it makes a lot of sense. This is the only way in which and we can protect our young ones. So this is the sacrifice we have to make. So let us go. And we have to present this idea to the king Leo, to the lion." So all the animals of the forest gathered and they went to meet the king lion, Leo. Let's see what happens now. So when Leo saw all the animals coming, he was very happy and he said to himself, "Ah, dinner is at my doorstep. Wonderful. What a day I have. My dinner is at my footstep. It came itself." All the animals bow down. Then Abu steps forward. So Abu said, "Your Majesty, it's our good luck that we have you as our king." So Leo was so proud and he said, "Well, thank you. What's the matter?" All the animals start looking at each other after the king asked. Abu replied, "Sir, it's natural that you have to kill us for your food. But killing more than what is required is making it difficult for us to go on. If you go on killing the animals without any purpose, without any reason, very soon a day will come when there will be no animal left in the forest for you to eat. So you will also die of hunger if you kill every animal without any reason." So Leo the king, he started roaring and said, "So what do you want?" Abu said, "Your Majesty, we have already discussed the problem among ourselves and have come upon a solution. We have decided to send one animal daily to your den. You can kill and eat it the way you like. This will also save you from the trouble of hunting. You don't have to go out every day to hunt. So every day you will get one animal to have for your dinner or lunch. You don't have to hunt and go outside." So the king Leo was very happy and said, "Fine, I agree with this, but make sure that the animal must reach to my den on time. Otherwise, I will be killing all the animals of the jungle. That animal should be there on time as my dinner or lunch. Be very careful about this thing." Students, I have discussed till page number 55 today. I will conclude the chapter in the next class. Till then, give a good reading of this story till page number 55 and you will write the hard words and the word meanings in the notebooks. That's all for today, students. Thank you.